study Unit 11, National Parks. Let's open your textbook, page 112. Now, before we start our lesson today, let's answer these following questions. Here are three questions. The first one, have you ever been to a national park? The second one, can you name some of the national parks in Vietnam and in the world? The third one, what trees and animals can you see in your national parks? Now, let's spend a few minutes thinking about these questions. And here are some suggestive answers that can help you to answer this. For the first one, there are two ways to answer it. If you say yes, you can say, yes, I have been to. Then you bless the name of the national park. For example, I say, yes, I have been to Phong Nha Kẻ Bàng National Park in Quảng Bình Province. If you say no, you can say, no, I haven't. Or you can say, no, I haven't been to any national park yet. For the second one, you can say, in Vietnam, there are Nam Cát Tiên National Park, Quốc Phương National Park, and Bạch Mã National Park. In the world, there are Yellowstone National Park in USA and Lake District National Park in Great Britain. For number three, you can say, we can see many species of animals and plants such as butterflies, 1,000-year-old tree, etc. And now, to help you to understand the reading passage, let's move to the next part, vocabulary. Now look at the first one. National park is a noun and the stress is on the word park, not national. The second one, locate. Locate is a verb and the stress is on the second one. Establish. Establish is a verb and the stress is on the second one. Remember that the ending sound sh, established. Rainforest. Remember that the stress is on the first one. When you say forest, the stress is on the word form. But when you say rainforest, it's on the rain. Hike. Hike is a verb and just one syllable, so you don't need to put the stress. In this case, it's a verb, but it is also a noun. If it's me noun, it's a dream people. The next one, contain. Contain is a verb and the stress is on the second one, contain. Next one, the adjective dependent. Dependent upon or dependent on, you can say. It is the same. The next word is survival. Survival is a noun and the stress is on the second one. You have to say survival. Survival is tồn tại, sự sống sót. Next one, feature. Feature is a noun and the stress is on the first one. Often. In this case, often is a noun and also a verb. If it's a noun, it means trẻ mồ côi. But it's a verb, it means làm cho mồ côi. Và trường hợp này người ta sử dụng bị động nhé các bạn. Often, the stress is on the first one. Next one, orphanage. Orphanage is a noun and the stress is on the first one. Abandon is a verb. It means từ bỏ, bỏ rơi. And the stress is on the second one. If you want to use an adjective, you can plus ed, abandoned, bị từ bỏ, bị ruồng bỏ. Take care of is a phrasal verb. It means look after or care for. Subtropical is an adjective. The stress is on the second one. Subtropical. Wilderness. Remember this one. You can say wildlife or wild, but when you say vùng hoang dã, it means wilderness. And the stress is on the first one. Now look at the next line. Tropical zone. Tropical zone is a narrow and stretchy on the first one. Temperate zone. Temperate zone. The stretchy on the first one and temperate in this case is an adjective. It means có nhiệt độ ôn hòa. Và chúng ta ghép lại thành là vùng ôn đới. Toxic. Toxic, the stretchy on the first one and it means poisonous. Độc hại. Chemical. Chemical is a countable noun and it means water. The stretchy on the first one is a chemical. Next one, contamination. Contamination, the stretchy on the fourth one and it means pollution. They are the same. Sự ô nhiễm. Due to in a preposition, the stretchy on the first one and it means thanks to, do good. And the last one, threaten. Threaten is a verb and the stretchy on the first one. Remember the pronunciation, threaten. That's all for vocabulary today and remember to practice it at home. It can help you to do pronunciation exercise very well. Now move to the next part while reading. Look at this picture. We are going to study some popular national parks in the world, including Vietnam. The first one is Quốc Phương National Park in Vietnam. The second one is Nairobi National Park in Kenya. And the last one is Everglades National Park in USA. Now to the first one. Quốc Phương National Park, Vietnam. Quốc Phương National Park is located 160 kilometers southwest of Hanoi. It is the first of Vietnam 9 national parks to be established, and it contains over 200 square kilometers of rainforest. Tourists go there to study butterflies, visit caves, high mountains, and look at the 1,000-year-old tree. The best time to visit the park is during the dry season, from October to April, when the rainy season is over. Here are some pictures about Quốc Phương National Park. You see? Now let's move to the next. Nairobi National Park in Kenya. Nairobi National Park is Kenya's smallest park, but you may be surprised at the large variety of animals that live there. Visitors, especially children, can go there to learn how to recognize the different species of animals and plants. They also learn about the habits of animals and how one species is dependent upon another for survival. An interesting feature of this park is the orphanage, where lots of orphaned or abandoned animals are taken care of. Here are some pictures about Nairobi National Park. Now, the last one, Everglades National Park, USA. Everglades Park National Park is a subtropical wilderness in the southeastern United States. This national park is special because it has plants and animals from both tropical and temperate zones. Due to an increase in population and the use of nearby land for farming, there are toxic levels of chemicals in the water. This contamination has threatened the park and many of the animals in it. After the first reading of these passages, now let's move to task one. In task one, you have to find the words in the passage that best suit it of the following definitions. Trong bài tập 1 này các bạn sẽ phải tìm từ trong đoạn văn mà có nghĩa phù hợp nhất với mỗi cái định nghĩa sau đây. Phương number 1, already done for you. To start an organization that is intended to continue for a long time. Để bắt đầu một cái tổ chức mà được dự định sẽ tiếp tục trong một thời gian dài. Thì trong bài chúng ta có từ là establish.
và số 1 đã được làm sẵn cho các bạn rồi. Now move to the next one. For number 2, it means to have something inside. In this case, you have to find out the word that is a verb. Có thứ gì đó ở bên trong ha, và chúng ta có một động từ mang nghĩa đó là contain. Contain is mean have something inside. The stress is on the second one, remember? Number 3. A group or groups of animals or plants. Một nhóm hoặc là các nhóm động thực vật. Ha, các bạn tìm trong bài chúng ta sẽ thấy có từ là species. Species is countable. It's a countable noun, both singular and plural form. Species, chủng loài hoặc là loài nha các bạn. Number 4. A state of continuing to live or exist. Một cái trạng thái mà tiếp tục sống hoặc là tồn tại. Trong bài chúng ta có từ là survival. Theo như nãy cô mới vừa nói xong, survival, sự sống sót, sự sinh tồn, tồn tại. Number 5. Related to an area near a tropical area. Có liên quan đến cái một khu vực gần với khu vực nhiệt đới ha. Gần vùng nhiệt đới thì các bạn có từ tính từ subtropical. And the last one, a state of being polluted. Một trạng thái bị ô nhiễm. Ở đây chúng ta đang cần một noun các bạn ha. Và từ đó là từ contamination, bằng nghĩa từ pollution nha các bạn. That's all for task 1. Now move to task 2. In task 2, you have to read the passage again and then you decide whether the statements are true or false. To do this task well, you have to find out the keywords in each sentence and then you compare with the information in the passage. Để làm được bài này thì các bạn nên tìm từ khóa trong mỗi câu ha. Sau đó các bạn đối chiếu so sánh với cái nội dung thông tin mình có trong mẫu văn. Từ đó chúng ta sẽ xác định được đúng hay sai. Đó là cách làm hiệu quả cho bài này. Now look at number 1. Kufur National Park is located 160 kilometers southeast of Hanoi. Và trong bài này, trong câu này thì cô tìm thấy từ khóa là 160 kilometers southeast of Hanoi. Ha, đó là hai từ khóa cần thiết mà các bạn cần phải nắm. Sau đây chúng ta sẽ so sánh với thông tin nhé các bạn. Now look at the information. Kufu National Park is located 160 kilometers southwest of Hanoi. So the difference is southeast and southwest. Are they different? Yes, of course. So it means that it is false. Đó, các bạn thấy một bên là southeast và một bên là southwest. Thành ra chúng ta thấy thông tin này nó khác nhau. Vậy chúng ta sẽ chọn là false nhé. Now move to the next one, number 2. December would be a suitable time to visit Kufu National Park. And the keywords in this sentence A, December, it may be a suitable time. The information here is the best time to visit the park is during the rice season, from October to April. Cái thời gian thích hợp nhất để tham quan cái công viên này là mùa vào mùa khô nha các bạn. Có nghĩa là từ tháng 10 cho đến tháng 4. Và thông tin chúng ta có ở đây là December. Ha, vì vậy chúng ta sẽ lấy từ này làm từ khóa và xác định nó là câu true. Nó nằm trong khoảng đó ha các bạn. Mùa khô. Now number 3. Nairobi National Park, which is small, has an animal variety. And the information here is Nairobi National Park is Kenya's smallest park, but you may be surprised at the large variety of animals that live there. An animal variety, and the information is large variety of animal, so they are the same. It's me. True. Number 4. Bay's National Park is a tropical wilderness in the southwest of the USA. Information here is Arrow Lakes National Park is a tropical wilderness in the southeastern United States. So, southwest and southeastern, they are different. This means this statement is false. Number 5. Water in Everglades National Park is not only clean but also fresh. Due to an increase in population and the use of nearby land for pumping, there are toxic levels of chemicals in the water. They are different, not only clean but also fresh, whereas in the information they say toxic levels. It's mean false. Now look through task 2. And now we move to task 3. In this task, you have to read the passages again and then answer the following questions. Here we have 6 questions. The first 3 questions. Now look at the first one. What is the area of the rainforest in Cúc Phương National Park? It's mean diện tích của rừng Cúc Phương là bao nhiêu? And the information we have here is it's the first of Vietnam 9 national parks to be established, and it contains over 200 square kilometers of rainforest. So your answer is the area of the rainforest in Cúc Phương National Park is over 200 square kilometers. That is the right answer. Number 2. Why would November be a suitable time to visit this park?
Tại sao tháng 11 là thời gian thích hợp để chúng ta đến tham quan cái công viên này?
Now look at the information. The best time to visit the park is during the dry season, from October to April when the rainy season is over.
Cái thời gian tốt nhất mà chúng ta đến tham quan cái công viên quốc gia này đó là trong và mùa khô, có nghĩa là từ tháng 10 cho đến tháng 4, nhưng mà khi mà mùa mưa đã đi qua rồi. Vậy tháng 11 là nằm trong khoảng thời gian đó.
So your answer is because the rainy season is over. Number 3. What can people learn in Nairobi National Park?
Chúng ta có thể tìm hiểu gì về vườn quốc gia Nairobi? Thông tin chúng ta có đây như sau.
They also learn about the habits of animals and how one species dependent upon another for survival.
Các trẻ em cũng có thể tìm hiểu về tập tính của các loài động vật và cách chúng phụ thuộc vào các loài với nhau để sống.
So the answer is they can learn about the habits of animals and how one species dependent upon another for survival. To next slide. Number 4. What kinds of animals are taken care of in the orphanage?
Các loài động vật nào thì được chăm sóc nuôi dưỡng ở cái trại mồ côi này?
And the information. An interesting feature of this park is the orphanage, where lots of orphaned or abandoned animals are taken care of. So your answer is in the orphanage, orphaned or abandoned animals are taken care of. Number 5. Why is Everglades National Park endangered?
Tại sao công viên quốc gia Everglades đang gặp nguy hiểm?
The information here, due to an increase in population and the use of nearby land for farming. There are toxic levels of chemicals in the water. So his answer is, Everglades National Park is endangered because of the toxic levels of chemicals in the water. Move to the last one, number six. What do you think will happen to Everglades National Park if more chemicals are released into the water?
Bạn nghĩ là điều gì sẽ xảy ra đối với cái công viên quốc gia Everglades này nếu như mà người ta thải ra ngày càng nhiều hóa chất hơn?
Information depend on you, depend on your answer. So you can say, if more chemicals are released into the water, when an animal will die or will be killed or will be destroyed.
À, nếu như nhiều hóa chất được thải xuống nước hơn thì các loài động thực vật sẽ có thể bị chết, hoặc bị giết, hoặc là bị hủy hoại ha các bạn.
Here are the answers for task 3. Now move to the last task. After reading, for this activity, you can do it at home by answering this question. Which of the three national parks would you like to visit most and why? Or you can discuss with your partner. That's all for our lesson today. Thank you for your attendance and goodbye. See you next lesson.